OBS Studio plugin, something I stayed away from for too long now. It is time for you to install your very first OBS plugin, or maybe it's the second, I don't know you. Anyways, we're going to be installing StreamFX, which is the plugin per excellence. I am personally installing it because it gives me additional filters. To be fair, you probably already watched your favorite Twitch guru tell you how to make the blur effect. Let me just show you how to download it and install it and all the capabilities that it has, or most of them at least. Oh, also I stream on Twitch, check me out there. The good news is that the first thing you need to do in order to find StreamFX, you go to Google, you type StreamFX. Wow, life is really easy. Click on the first link, boom, it's gonna bring you there. There's gonna be a lot of things. Click on go to download, it's gonna bring you to the download page. Now there's an installation guide, which you actually want to read, especially if you're having issues installing it. Let's hope that we don't. This is my actual first time installing it. So once you're done, go all the way down there and find the .exe that has to do with Windows. Let's go with that one, shall we? We're gonna click okay, we're gonna download it. It's gonna take a little bit, and then we're gonna click on that file that we just downloaded. It's probably gonna open up a setup. We're gonna click next, next, next. You know how those things go. Click install for all users. Boom, I accept the agreement. Read all of it. Make sure that you read every single, just kidding. Click static if you installed OBS from the normal OBS setup. Portable if you have OBS portable. Select the destination. I'm gonna pick C, my main hard drive. The folder, but it already exists. Would you like to install in that folder anyways? Yes, next. Install, boom, finished. From there, if OBS was running when you installed it, you'll want to restart it, and this is what you're gonna be greeted with. Maybe there's gonna be something about GitHub, just click okay, click okay, boom. You will see that you have a new tab up here that says StreamFX. We're gonna have all the information that you actually need about it, but the most important part for me, at least, let's go to my main scene here where my camera is, and let's go find those filters. I'm gonna right click on my camera, go to filters, and I'm gonna click plus, and I'm gonna see if anything changed. And indeed, I have a couple more filters than the original OBS. I have 3D transform, blur. You guys are familiar with this one, probably. You know, you can blur the screen. Oh, cool, cool, blur. I have color grading, I have dynamic mask, I have SDF effects, and I have shader. I believe that's it. 3D transform, what does it do? Well, it allows you to skew the corners of a 2D source in order to give the impression of perspective. So here I have top left. If I do this, there we go. And basically I can use this to pretend that this 2D image is 3D. Of course, if you watch my other videos, you will know about Polypop, where it's real 3D, so all you would have to do is just rotate the camera. But in this case, it's cool that we have that straight into OBS. So the blur, I don't think I need to explain the blur to you. Hey, there's types of blur, there's Gaussian blur, box linear, blah, blah, blah. The area, directional, so it goes in a specific direction. In that case, I believe it's up. And then there's the angles, you can go, you know, wide, up, whatever. Is there zoom? Yes, there's zoom. So that's pretty cool. Play around with the percentage and go, whoa, oh no, what is going on? I'm into the, okay, whatever. Color grading, it's better than color correction. Basically, you can really, really go ahead and change, modify how the colors are appearing on screen, basically on your camera or whatever source. Then we have SDF effects. Let's click okay, let's add it. And this is where we have a lot of things. We have outer shadows, which is basically a drop shadow. I don't think I can even demonstrate that. So after looking up exactly why the SDF effects weren't working, turns out that your source needs to have a little bit of transparency. In this case, I went and added this image source, which has transparency all over, added the filter to it, and it seemed to be working. If I go outer shadow, boom, we have an outer shadow, and we can play around with it. Maybe not too much, just like that. And this is what it does. So on any source, you can do this as long as there's a little bit of transparency somewhere, okay? So that's outer shadow, inner shadow. It's gonna be the same thing, but inside. Turn off the outer shadow, boom, outer glow. You know what that does, maybe you don't. Anyways, it makes it glow on the outside, hence the name outer glow. Inner glow, it glows on the inside. Yes, congrats, there you go, boom, boom, boom. And outline is just a solid line, not that solid actually. And you can offset it a little bit, boom, boom. You can play around with the sharpness. So now it's a solid line anyways. And let's go back to the image. I'm gonna right click, go to filters. This is my camera. And now I'm gonna add a shader. Cool thing with this shader is that StreamFX already comes with some shaders pre-installed. So all you have to do when you apply the shader here is go to browse and then go to shaders. Go to filters if you wanna use a filter, source, whatever. Just look around and try a couple of things. Here, the bulge pinch is that one. gives you that effect, right? And there's a couple more, and they basically play around with the shape and the colors of whatever source you're using it on. Hexagonize, what is that? It's a bunch of hexagons. So that is pretty interesting. You can do a bunch of effects like that. One thing we have here is dynamic mask. That's gonna be the other one. And we can pick an input source, just like a normal image blend mask that I use on my tutorials to basically make different camera shapes and stuff. Dynamic mask is the same thing, but it's compatible with moving things. Anyways, let's find input source and let's find our image, which is image 2. Let me go to alpha channel, alpha input value. Oh, there you go. You can see you can see the shape of the kappa here. Oh my God. Basically, I need to play around with this somewhere in order to do the invert version of whatever I'm doing right now. So I'll bring the base value up and I'll bring the alpha input value down. And there you go. I have a kappa shaped mask. You wouldn't use it like that, but basically if you have like a green screen video and it's moving, it will move the mask. It's very practical. Trust me. Trust me. There you go. Also, aspect ratio, it doesn't respect it at all. So you want to go with something that has pretty much the same aspect ratio if you can. Anyways, that's all I'm willing to show you about StreamFX. Hopefully you followed along and you installed and you know how it works now. And you can see that it's not that complicated. You just click install, next, install, restart OBS, and then add some filters. There's probably a bunch of other stuff that it does. Just check it out. I'm also new to it, so don't ask me too much. Anyways, go follow me on Twitch, and I will see you guys next time. Go out there, make me proud, guy level. Audi.